business scenarios. And then on the data model side, you have to use, or you are going to store the structured data, so you need database for it. So let's start with the first component, that is the user interface. And post.com has, on the left hand side, you can see the declarative components of the view or user interface part, and those are applications, tabs, page layouts, record types, and text boxes, buttons, and all these things. If you want to have more control over your user interface, you want to add more custom UI to it, you can use the programmatic model, that is the post.com pages, sites, and they have Visual Force UI framework. It is similar to maybe in Java domain like JSP tag or struts tag. Let's move towards the second part, that is business logic. In business logic, Salesforce has workflows, validation rules, approval processes, and also security and sharing. That means you can secure your data based on the roles. You can restrict accesses to your records or data based on the hierarchy in your organization. So these kind of features are available as part of declarative in business logic. And in programmatic side, you can have controllers like similar to servlets in Java or controllers, struts controllers. And Salesforce or post.com has its own language of called Apex. It's similar to .NET programming or Java programming. And they have web services, APIs, and triggers also. So you can, from the names, you can directly correlate with the traditional